What up, friends? It is time for a FREEview of the Lost Zane recordings from November 14th, 2016 is what this show is taken from. We had just finished up doing our live show, the first ever Eric Zane show live, and we were kind of like talking about it on this edition of the show on 107.3 WBBL. I release these twice a week. You know, a look back, an audio time capsule, if you will. I give you a free view of it right now if you want the full show. It's at patreon.com/Eric Zane. Check out my Patreon just to see what it's all about. patreon.com/Eric Zane. The cash that you spend, $5 or $10 a month for all of the 15 plus hours a week in content, really helps keep this racket growing. Thank you if you've helped out in the past or you've signed up for it in the past. And I really, really appreciate that. Of course, always I just appreciate your time for checking this out, the free view of the Lost Zane recordings. Enjoy it.
Good morning, bright and early, November 14th, the Eric Zane Show. Welcome in to 107.3 WBBL. It was 1 week ago that we started this show, and the mics felt a little weird. I can't normally tell, Julius. Is there anything strange out? Is it the new headphones that I'm borrowing?
Probably. Everything sounds
fine, good to you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. I trust you a hell of a lot more than I trust me.
Especially those headphones.
They're pretty rinky-dink. I left everything in the trunk of my car after the live show. I threw it all in the back, and I was like, I got the hell out of there. And I try not to think about radio much at all over the weekend. The show went up very well. I kind of like bottle it up and do it again. Worked very, very well. Everybody seemed to enjoy themselves.
Especially once the drinks started flowing.
Wow. Boy, did we get funny then. Then I knew I could pull off an interview with the legendary Frank Eimer Band. when... It's like, oh, yeah. I knew we could do it. I think one of the low points was when I thought I was speaking into the microphone. But in fact, I was speaking into a non-working microphone.
Empty microphone.
And I thought that there was something wrong with the entire setup when, in fact, we were on the air. But I was just speaking into the wrong microphone while the rejoin music played for like 15 minutes, it seemed. I don't know what's going on. That was a low point.
I think we're on. No, I can't hear myself. Okay. I think we're on.
Oh, man. I'd still be there right now doing it. Yeah, everybody, thanks for coming out. That was fun. My dad was a huge hit. He had no idea.
He was just as surprised by the turnout as I was.
Even more so, every time I've told him, forget the attendance. You know as well as I do that everybody loves the Dear Meathead segment.
Oh, yeah.
But no matter how many times I would tell him that.
No.
He was like, no way, guy. No. Yeah, are you sure people like this guy? Yeah, Dad. I mean, it's
your listeners are stupid.
And he's like,
he might not have said.
No, he wouldn't. He never would. He was like, now should I maybe like? And he's trying to tell me like, he's asking me things ahead of time. Should I like, get mad? And I go, no. I go, look,
you're on the phone.
Yes, just talk like you normally do. This is just you being you. If you do anything other than be yourself, it will be phony, and you don't want that. I mean, just answer things the way you normally would. And so he did. And, boy, he was very, very concerned about and very nervous. I told you when we started the show on earlier, that he was just seemed really right. Nervous and on edge about the whole thing. But you'd never know it.
I mean, oh, no, he was comfortable as all hell.
Yeah. And that I shot a video and I posted it to Facebook. Of him when he interacted with Griffin's captain, Nathan Pache. And the reason why I wanted that to happen, that was why I wanted Pache there just for that moment when they reacted with each other or interacted, because Pache really loves my dad's segments. He really likes my dad. So I just wanted to get that. Now, So I'm telling my dad ahead of time, we're driving around downtown on Thursday night, and I go, now, Dad, the captain of the Griffins is a big fan of yours.
He is!
Yeah. Yeah, he's, you know, he's a veteran player, and he's, I tried to reference and make it clear that Nathan is, is also a big leadership role for the younger players. Mm-hmm. So he's kind of like that go-between on-ice play and coaching. And I think Nathan has kind of accepted that that's where he's going to do what he's going to do right. for the remainder of his years. Now, I'm not being I'm trying not to be insulting, but I don't think Nate's going to be running up to the Redwings with regular intervals because
I don't know if he can even. I don't think he has a two-way contract. I thought he was just signed strictly by the Griffins.
Exactly.
The Redwings could buy his contract, yes. but it would be a longer process than just
my point
pulling
is,
a Mantha.
It's different with Nathan than it would be with, like what you said,
right.
Mantha or Tyler Bertuzzi mm-hmm. or whatever.
Because they're owned by the Red Wings.
Exactly.
Page is owned by the Griffins.
There are only a handful of players that are Griffin responsibility in terms of what they make. So
he was comfortable enough to buy a house.
Yeah. You know, I mean, Nate has a great, great life, and we love him dearly. But my dad is not familiar with all of what
AHL
I just
rules.
Said.
Yeah.
He has no idea. And he thinks that Nathan is regularly going up to the Red Wings. And he hasn't. So, but we're driving around downtown, and Nate is on the side of Van Andel Arena. You know, they've got his image.
Just put your dad on the side of Van Andel next to him.
And I go, Dad, that's the guy who wants to meet you. He's a huge fan. He goes, ooh, and I'm pointing right at it, and it's right in front of us. I go,
the guy on the
three-story man on the side of the hockey rink. Oh, hey, there, yeah. So I explained it to him, but I don't know if it was registering. It was just kind of weird.
Didn't seem that way.
So then fast forward to Friday morning, and I go, and there's a video on our Facebook page of this interaction. And he goes, hey, Nathan, the Red Wings need you, guy. You got to get back there.
I mean, after watching that Montreal game on Saturday
True,
night,
yeah,
I think they could use anyone. My God.
It was just funny to hear him, like, implying that he's been up and down.
Yeah.
You know? Because he has no idea. My dad has no clue. But, yeah, that was very... And then my dad grabs his face. He actually grabbed his face. Goes, oh, Nathan, my boy!
I felt awkward for Nathan.
Oh, my God. Just so much going on there. A good time. So, is the supermoon overrated to you?
Well, I saw it earlier than when it was at its peak.
Yeah.
Like, I saw it around 7, maybe? 7 p.m.?
Yeah.
And it was enormous. But then once it went higher up in the sky, it became small. So, it's kind of a
Now, you know why that is, don't you?
Because the Earth's rotation.
Well, it's... No. Now, I'm not saying... But the reason why it looks so much bigger when it's lower cool. is because of the they call them visual cues, okay. buildings, trees, things like that. It's really slowly working its way in,
mm-hmm.
but it's not really that much. It's not bigger at all when it's on the
right.
rise into when it's high in the sky. So, yeah, it was big and bright. And it's funny because I had a website open when it was like 0.50 degrees above the horizon, which I couldn't see it then.
Mm-hmm.
And then it had the mileage that it was from the Earth, 207 or 221,706 miles. And then after about 10 minutes, 221,705 miles. It's getting closer.
Mm-hmm.
And it's actually showing you that as it goes degree by degree up into the sky. And, you know, by the time it got to be the time that you saw it, I went out and looked at it. And I went, okay, maybe a little brighter.
It didn't look bright, but it looked enormous to me.
And people were like freaking out.
It's very overrated.
Oh my gosh! And now, as of 7:17 this morning,
it just looks like a moon.
That at 7:17 or right about then, that is when it will be the absolute closest that it has been in 70 years.
Really?
Yeah. And it's going to look the same as it did when you saw it, and when we've ever seen it, because it's the moon. The only thing I noticed somewhat was the brightness.
It was brighter. I'll give it that. But it wasn't like, I wasn't impressed. Except for when I was driving, like I said, around 7 o'clock. It looked nice.
Yeah, it's like, come on. It seems like it's amateur day.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you 24/7 with supplies and solutions for every industry and access to product specialists ready to help. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
It's the biggest March ever. Big premieres, big families, and big surprises. This month on Disney Plus, stream blockbusters like West Side Story, Free Guy, and Disney's Encanto. As well as original movies and series like Olivia Rodrigo Driving Home to You, Cheaper by the Dozen, Pixar's Turning Red, and Marvel Studios' Moon Knight. All of these and more streaming this month on Disney Plus.
I've got this badass telescope that I still struggle to use. And part of it is because
you're looking at the wrong end.
There's too much light. Too much light where we live.
And then even in Hudsonville?
Yeah. And then when we traveled to a place where there was virtually no light,
there was nothing to look at.
I forgot the telescope.
Oh, stupid.
You know, there's a dark park in Traverse City.
A dark park?
Yes. If you, I forgot the name of it, but if you were to just write Traverse City Dark Park, you would see the name of it. It's protected from all light pollution.
How is that?
You can't have, there's no lights. They just made it in the area where there weren't a lot to begin with, and then they shut them all down. You walk in from the trailhead, and it takes you right to the shore of the lake, and it's pitch black. And if there is no moon out, or even close to it, if the moon is you know, on the other side of the planet, I mean, you can see the bands of the Milky Way unbelievably.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Which is just really, really, I mean, all the nebula gases, you can see them light up in the sky. Not that far from here. And there aren't that many of those in the U.S., those dark parks. So Ernie and Jackie and two of their pals went to Chicago for the weekend. Have you heard of the show One Tree Hill?
I've heard of it. Okay. Never seen an episode.
Nor have I. But Jackie, my daughter, is the biggest fan of this show.
Might be the only fan of that show.
Well, I think they all met in Chicago because there was a convention.
A convention?
Yes.
Show's been over for like 4 years.
Well, it has this cult status where girls about Jackie's age have just continually, have really glommed onto it for some reason.
She probably likes Chad Michael Murray.
I think that might be one of the people that she's really, really sweet on. And what you do is you pay
sweet
like
on.
$300. That's an old person term.
Yeah, it
really
is.
You pay like $300, and then you go to this hotel, and you have a weekend of One Tree Hill activities.
Ooh.
With the stars of the show there.
Ooh.
Culminating with a nice dinner.
Ooh.
Where stars from the show will come around and like take pictures of you. Now, Jackie...
They take pictures of you, or you take pictures of them?
I'm sorry, you take pictures with them.
Oh, that'd be something.
Yeah. And so she was just completely stoked because she's got pictures of her with these people. And I don't
With these B-list actors?
Yeah, I don't even know what they do now, but she is just so wrapped up in this show. Well, while that was all going on, because Ernie didn't want to take part in it, and Jackie's the only one taking part in the activities. Ernie, his friend Alex, and Alex's girlfriend are walking around downtown Chicago.
Yeah, Chicago's nice.
Okay. And
there's plenty to do there.
They decided to go see that big, gigantic, reflective bean.
Really?
Just to walk around. You know, there's just something to do.
Go to a bar.
And this is the middle of the day, and all of a sudden, they realize there is anti-Trump rally walking down the street.
Oh, good.
And was just 100 people, but then it quickly swelled. Ernie has video of a woman holding a sign, and it says, "I dare you to grab my pee." And it's spelled out, and I'm like, oh, no, man. She's really pissed. So, okay, I dare you to grab my peas as she walks by. And he's just observing it. And Alex is standing there. And then he says out loud, he goes, man, what a waste of time. It's crazy that these people are doing all this. How does this help anything? Now that the election is over, how does this help? So he says that, and a person standing next to him is from the Chicago Sun-Times and notices that and wants to get a point of view from someone like him. And so this reporter realizes, well, this is the person to ask. My job is done here as soon as I get a comment from Alex.
Did it make the news?
It did.
Oh, boy.
And I've got the clip here, the snippet from the Chicago Sun-Times. And they spelt the name wrong that he gave, which is a big bummer on the story. But he said, Alex, people are just pissed because someone that they don't like is president. That's all it is. He then was quoted with, I don't like Trump. I don't like Hillary Clinton. But why are we doing this? We need to come together now. The name he gave because he didn't want to give his real name.
Oh, God.
Bill Simonson. Alex is a big fan of Bill's show, and he knows in this show, too. And he probably knew we'd talk about it now. And the thing is, they wrote Bill Simmons.
I saw that.
Or Bill Simons. They wrote Bill Simons. S-I-M-O-N-S. And it's like, oh, God.
How funny would that have been?
Oh, they were so close, but the reporter fumbled the ball. They said, say your name into the microphone. He goes, Bill Simonson from Detroit.
Sam Charles. Good job, Sam.
As the protesters walked past him in Millennium Park, Bill Simons of Detroit could be heard saying, this is what's wrong with America. This is what's wrong with America. What did 6683 and huge? So that happens, and then Ernie immediately, after the story was published, screenshotted it, sent it to me. So we're walking downtown, and we ended up in a Donald Trump protest. Chrysler was interviewed by the Chicago Sun-Times, and he told them his name was Bill Simonson. Oh, man, so close.
Maybe they knew Bill used to work in Chicago. Maybe this writer didn't like Bill's show. I'm not writing Bill Simonson.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, that was a long time ago that Billy was there, but he was prominent in the radio landscape, as he is here. In the next segment, it was a, you had ups and downs for a lot of reasons with sports.
Yeah.
And we'll talk about those things next, and we may get into introducing you to Mr. Black Friday. If we don't do it now, we'll introduce you to Mr. Black Friday a bit later on, because we're always short on time. There's a video we'll be posting from the live show that Mike Pellerito recorded a ton of footage for, and he set it to music. He set it to Todd Rundgren, banging drum all day.
Oh, good.
And we'll post that so you can get a sense of some of the things that went on the first ever live show over at the American Legion. Man, those people were happy. We had a good time with them. They want us back. I can't wait to do it. And we'll talk about that and a ton of other things, too. Do we have something to give away today, do you know?
I believe we do.
Got to have Griffin's tickets.
Yes, I think we have Griffin's tickets for Wednesday's game that we didn't give away on Friday. So we might have that.
Nice. All right. We'll get into that stuff and a whole lot more. And if anybody asks you who you listen to, please tell them the Eric Zane Show on 107.3 WBBL.
That's it. My free view of the Lost Zane Recordings full show, released twice a week, Mondays and Fridays, at patreon.com/Eric Zane. Thanks, folks. Bye-bye.